Hello, everybody, and welcome to Weekend Binge. And I just like Happy Labor Day weekend to you all. That's why I'm playing this song, because this song relates to working and keep you going like a bullet train. So, right here, today on Binge, we're going to be talking after stuff. So, sorry for the pandemic. So, with that being said, let's get binging, America!
Moving like the speed of...
I am Matthew Taylor, and welcome to another episode of the Weekend Binge, Labor Day Weekend Edition. Now, if you're wondering, if I say Labor Day, this ain't related to no work stuff, and neither will be the title, because I don't own Christina Miller's nude picture. If I did, I would have been CEO of Turner Entertainment right now, and I would not be doing this show at this very moment. But, let's not get ourselves worked up over that. And let's just get to why I'm here today. I am here to talk about Boomerang's newest stuff. Previously on my Boomerang Man, I talked about how much of a turd pile it is and how it should not happen at all. How it should not even exist. How it should not even be done. Which all meant the same thing. Today, I'm going to show you at least one good thing that can come out of this rebrand of their newest original programming. And that, my friends, is Wabbit. Are you ready for some footage? Well then, here it is.
Yep.
I am Sir Little Chin. I'm here to slay a dragon.
No dragons here, Doc. Just a rabbit and a very noisy squirrel. Five, six, seven, eight.
Wow, wasn't that amazing? Actually, it is. I'm not gonna lie about that. But there is one horrible turd pile that's gonna possibly be coming out of this rebrand. And I'm not gonna like it one bit. And that is... Bunnicula Scooby-Doo. Starting October 5th, if I'm correct, Bunnicula Scooby-Doo will be the biggest turd on Boomerang ever to hit Boomerang since the rebrand. It's horrible. Look at his eyes! His eyes look like he's nervous to do it. Like he's saying, don't do it. Just don't do it. It's not gonna work out. It's not going to work. The characters also look the same way, too. It's horrible. You want to hear the plot? It's about them spending the last few minutes of summer together. Wow, isn't this going to be like a teen beach film? I hope that's going to become like Mystery Incorporated. Well, alright then. Now I got myself worked up over that. It's time to give my original thoughts about it. Well, my prayers are that... That the show doesn't horribly come as worse as its predecessor, which was Scooby-Doo Mystery Incorporated. Because it doesn't belong to be that kind of way. Wait, even I don't want it to be that way. But I don't know what Boomerang or Warner Bros. Animation is going to do for I don't know what trump card Warner Bros. Is going to pull for this. Or Boomerang, it could be whoever. Possibly Cartoon Network. Alright then, now that we got that part out of the way, let's talk about another show that I'm not so sure about. And that show is Bunnicula. or the Ed way to say Dracula. Let's fast forward to the day it happened. Give me a sec. You gotta be somewhere here. Well, I guess this is it. Bunnicula is originally a book written by someone, I don't care, but it was named the best-selling books of any time, whatever. The story usually follows just how a cat and a dog found some wabbit bit who drinks vegetable juice, if I'm correct, to activate his super normal activities. I sound retarded. But still, I don't know why that screen is glitching for, but as you see, they're complaining because they're sucked juice out of vegetable juice to alert their paranormal activities. Now, once I was looking up the show online, I heard that one of the commenters was actually a writer on this newer version. I am scared. I am horribly terrified of what he just said. I don't know him, but Maxwell Adams, the creator of Billy and Mandy, on this? Jesus, Lord, help me. I'm already thinking about how much fart jokes and innuendos is going to be crammed into that episode. God, help me. And I ain't just saying this out of sarcasm. I'm really scared for this show. This is another thing I'm scared of. Scooby-Doo, it's a lost cause nowadays. Warner Brothers, Cartoon, if Warner Brothers can stomp over it, if Cartoon Network can stomp all over it, and now if Boomerang can stomp all over it, it's done for. It's just done. Scooby-Doo's done now. It's been 45 years of them doing solving mysteries, and it's over. It's all over, and there's Bunnicula himself. But reminder, he won't look like that. He'll have things on top of his head, look like some kind of, like if Count Von Clock, or whatever the heck his name is, had sex with Bugs Bunny. Bugs Bunny's son, I forgot his name, I think it was Jasper or something. He had sex with him and got that kind of offspring. Well, yeah. Anyway, this is Bunnicula. This is not the actual cartoon. This is just an old cartoon from back in the days. Way back in the days. Back when Hanna-Barbera and stuff like that was the gist of things. Reminder, I don't own nothing here. And I guess that'll do it for today's episode of Binge, I guess. Boomerang, if you're listening out there, please, please think about what you're doing. You are really about a hair's deep from putting yourself into a crap hole. You're already in a crap hole, but you need to pull yourself out of it before you do more harm to yourself. Alright? Alright then, this is Matthew Taylor saying, remember, I'm not a nigger. I'm just a white nigger.